If I want him to take an angle back, I step that way and give him the back and he'll go that way. He may be inadvertently doing it.
I'm saying, like, I didn't. When I gave her a leg of the back, she turned it straight back. But just one day, just to test it, I gave an angle, I put my hand like that, and she took an angle.
Yeah.
And right. If I was raising her straight, she'd take me a straight back. Just take an angle without having to do any kind of
thing. I can tell you, don't overuse it. Because what will happen here, she'll start, it's not distinguishing between the two, and you'll give her a back and she'll take it in. She's using it when you have to.
We can see
some of the
hunt
tests, we
don't do it
in time. And that's what I'm trying to get at. Don't use it a whole lot. Because, it's, you know, it's 150 yards, this, here, and that's
the bar.
Depending on the background,
good.
I tried here. That the first time. I mean,
here.
I never liked it. I mean, she may work out. You may like it. I mean, try it.
Here.
I kind of just confuses them there. And believe me, most judges, if you don't like it, you can square. They have no problem if you get them open. You cut them over to get them back on the line.
Back.
One thing that's easy that I'm liking about it right now, that's better, is. You know how she is. She gets down at her feet really easy.
Oh, yeah.
And if she starts getting up on her, I gotta stop her and send her over to get her back on, and then almost immediately
yeah.
Stop her again.
You're breaking the momentum.
And I keep giving her whistles. She starts getting down on herself, and then she don't want to listen.
If you've got to blow 20 whistles to get them to the blind, but the young dog usually by the stop 6 or 7. You got as many whistles as you can.